In the quest to know what majority of Kamparans feed on, I visited many local restaurants, markets, and homes in the city and its suburbs. For time memorial, matoke has been the favorite food and locals in and around Kampala. But in recent years, a deadly bacterial disease known as banana wilt has devastated matoke gardens, driving many farmers to abandon the crop and pushing the price high and out of reach for many. A matoke bunch now ranges between 20,000 shillings and 40,000 shillings, pushing most families in Kampala to give up on the regional staple.
Times have changed. People no longer buy foodstuffs. They used to like matoke, but they now prefer rice and maize flour.
These days, things are not easier. Food are expensive, banana. So now, this Christmas season, for me, I will use rice because I have no money.
On the outskirts of Kampala, you'll notice that the booming business is selling chapati or its derivatives, like Rolex. Sarong Abdubamuleke, a resident of Makindi, has been in this business for 5 years. He says majority of low-income earners now feed on chapati, not only for breakfast, but they too take it for lunch and supper. The cheapest chapati combination is with beans in what is called chikomando.
People these days like chapati, and we from Soga have spread this to Uganda. And due to low incomes, that people prefer cheaper foods which are very easy to prepare.
That's our food, by the way. We used to take chapati because we have no money. We used to take chikomando. Chikomando is for 1,000, 1,500 there.
Grains have taken center stage, and a poor family now typically feeds on rice or posho with beans. Spaghetti or macaroni is these days used so much by many families. A recent contribution from Kenya to Kampala's diet is sukuma wheat leaves. The poor man is sauce that grows very easily in the smallest of places.
I buy rice or posho at home. Matoke is very expensive for families.
When you use rice and posho, there is no need of getting where you put your garbage. Because you know here in Kampala, when you have garbage, you have to care for it.
Away from poor families and their food types that are considered cheap and easier to prepare, middle-class families have adopted expensive but dangerous foods, which health officials say are responsible for the increased diabetes, cancer, and heart diseases. These are the oily, junky foods like fried chicken, chips, and fried meat. Fast food restaurants and makeshift joints have sprung up all over Kampala. But on a positive note, the corporate class has embraced a new dietary culture that emphasizes fruits. In the mornings, many office workers are served assorted fruits like jackfruit, pineapples, pawpaws, and sugar canes by fruit vendors. A pack of fruit salads is affordable at only 1,000 shillings. People who have no time to prepare take this advantage. Many people are also turning away from alcoholic drinks and going for fruit juice cocktails. Just like the Bible talks of the poor, the rich will also always be with us, and their interest must be catered for. So exotic restaurants from faraway lands like China, India, and Italy have also got their space. Prices charged for a meal in these places are simply out of reach for any average worker. But they are doing good business because the rich want them. In Kampala today, there's something to eat for everybody. It all depends on the depth of your pocket.
With my interaction with most of the people in Kampala, especially those who work downtown, I've just come to conclude that people don't have faith on what they desire, but it's what you have in your pocket that determines what you have either for lunch, supper or breakfast. Many have now opted to have rice, posho or chapati just because they are cheaper and easy to prepare. Juliet Namoya, Aban TV.